And here it goes, getting into the air. Wow. This is the Buttle Biplane. Strike aircraft, S2S model of the Pitt Special. One reason you couldn't see very well when the aircraft appears in plan form to you is the design. Very uncomfortable. While being affected there by negative G as opposed to positive. And even more so as he performs an outside half loop. Showing him how much you have enjoyed his display. There's the bow, and he's coming in for his final pass. Thus increase the aircraft's range and performance.
And that huge barn door of a wing would give it that lift that it would need.
An attribute that would have been used in wartime while engaged in lower level missions. Here come the 2022 Team Raven. Flight on the Universities of Wales Air Squadron at St Athlone. as they take to the B axis, running in towards us, pulling up, and about to perform upward rolls to the right. In for a barrel roll. This so named because the aircraft will, in effect, describe the outline of the inside of a barrel. Us in an echelon formation into that barrel roll, but changing in the course of it to line astern. Changing. Pulling up out of that echelon formation. The other newcomer to the lineup for 2022 is Raven 3, Russ Eatwell. Very well known on the display circuit as a former display pilot for the Royal Navy on the sea area. He's back in the air shuttle after an 8-year break. Now with smoke on, Simon Shirley calling the pull up, rolling the team left as they get ready to perform their Delta downwards bomb burst. That was the display by 2022's Team Raven. Used to have starts off with triplane. It's recently been sold, but it's not the team anymore. The DR1 quickly two stand-down machine guns. He was built to the tune of very small numbers. He was superbly agile in turning the flight, though it was slower in terms of outright performance than a lot of the Allied aircraft that was going up against.
Oh, yeah.
Two of the SE-5A replicas turning tight to get onto the tail of the DR1 that's heading towards the east, and the Junkers CL1 that it's in formation with. The SE-5A reminds us that the term fighter wasn't really in use at the time of the 1914-18 war. They used the term scout instead. And SE in this aircraft designation stands for Scout Experimental. These aircraft owned by individual time offenders. The triplane with the black and white tail, which is the one up high at the moment, just at display centre, is actually owned by Bruce Dickinson of Iron Maiden, and it represents a DR1 from Jagdstaffel, or Fighter Squadron 6, flown by Lieutenant Johan Janssen. Experienced in the Korean War combats, not least due to their Second World War experiences. That airframe, the one that's represented by this aircraft's colour scheme today, was repaired to static display standard, and you can see it today in the National Museum of the US Air Force at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base. Aircraft designs, the Vampire. The twin boom layout, incidentally, with these twin tail booms, was chosen so that they could make the jet pipe shorter and minimise the loss of thrust from the single engine. That was a power plant developed by Frank Halford, who for many years had been De Havilland's engine man, as the Halford H1. Thank you. named after an American educational establishment, being an aircraft of US design.
Which is the plane just now behind the number one. The Fokker S11 with a couple of other pilots.
Nothing else. Good boy. Out. flies through the air and one that makes for a great photograph. As I said, it's doing slightly different to what was in the schedule, so please just enjoy any extras we get from them. And finally, here we have it. Finishing the slide, James will now accelerate down the right line, ready to catch up with the other aircraft. As a member of the Red Arrows, James had the privilege of leading the synchro pair, so he's quite used to flying fast and low, but normally with another jet coming the other way.
Such as this is a vastly expensive business.
It certainly doesn't get any cheaper as the years go on. And through this aeroplane's continued operation, we salute the tens of thousands of Allied airmen who lost their lives while operating in the European theatre during World War II. And it's their show act that certainly we very much hope will continue to inspire us for many decades to come. Raid by 8th Air Force B-17s in the European theatre. Indeed, here at Duxford as the Spitfire PR-11 gets airborne. Reconnaissance Supermarine Spitfire PR-11 that's become known as the NHS Spitfire. A really varied day's flying at the Duxford Summer Air Show 2022. We were lucky a few items today because of the weather, but I think you'll all agree it's still been a very fun afternoon of flying.
It certainly has, and we've seen some spectacular